Vikings, hi everybody, you all are very much welcome once again to our YouTube channel. This is the Villa House of Information and Entertainment, and right here it's your girl Villa Mama. On today's video, I'm going to be talking about six unnoticed workplace practices that might cost you your job. Six unnoticed workplace practices that might cost you your job. First of all, I want to welcome all my new subscribers. If you're new to this channel, you're gonna definitely like it here. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share my videos. And of course, you can drop your comment down below in the comment section. Yes, that's because I always reply to my comments. That's the way I interact with my audience. So guys, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and drop your comment down below. So on this video, I'm going to be talking to you guys about six unnoticed workplace behaviors that so many people think they are minute things, but actually there are things that can cost you your job. Yes, these are behaviors that you might just you might have been practicing them, and you do not think, or you do not look at them like they are things that can really mean anything, but people are diverse and people really take some actions so serious. So on this video, I'm going to be telling you guys how you can be able to work on that and how you can be able to make a change at your workplace. Yeah, so the first point is the failure to greet your fellow colleagues. Yeah, this is very important. If you have a very good relationship with your fellow workers, your colleagues, you have to always greet them in the morning. Like if you come in the morning, you have to say good morning, good afternoon, good evening. And even when you're leaving the workplace, you have to greet your colleagues and you say, hey, though, goodbye, and things like that. But some people fail to greet, and others, they look at, you have to greet everybody, including the security, including the bodyguards, whosoever, even subordinates. You have to greet them because this is an important aspect when it comes to peer review. During peer review, these are the things that your colleagues will be talking about you, and it's going to give you a plus. But for some people, they fail to greet. They'll just be like, oh, why should I greet you? You're my subordinate. You're supposed to greet me. But no, those things can cost you your job. So it's very important to greet your colleagues when you come in the office and when you're leaving the office. And the second thing, which is very important, is when you sign in and out of your workplace. This is another very important aspect because I have been a victim of this as well. So I'm talking out of experience. When you get to your working place, if it requires you to change your clothes before you sign in, then you have to do so. Because for some people, when they just get to work, they just sign in with their clothes. Well, it all depends on your workplace. If you have to change your clothes and then get into the attire, your working attire, then you have to change your clothes and then you get on your working attire before you can sign in on the time plan. But for some other workplaces that you do not require that, or you just, when you get to work and then you have to just sign in, then you can do that without changing your clothes. So this is also very important, and you have to be very honest when you sign in and out of your working place. So many people might think that this is a minor thing, but such things might cost you your job. Yes, because they might look at you like you're dishonest, like you're not an honest person. So you need to be very sincere when you sign in and out of your working place. The third thing, which is one of the behaviors which might cost you your job, is the dress code. For some people or for some offices, they require that on Wednesdays you appear in this fabric, on Fridays you appear in t-shirts, on Mondays you come in suits. Some workplaces are like that. They require that their workers should put on specific outfits on specific days, and also sometimes they require that you put on specific colors or on specific days. So these are some of the things that you need to respect, because you do not have to be unique. Don't try to be unique from the group. You have to be part of the group. If they say today it's this color we are wearing, if it's all white, you have to be white and in black pants. if it's t-shirts and black pants, then you also have to respect the rules, because evaluation might affect you. Yeah, evaluation might affect you, because sometimes workplaces they have meetings that they do evaluation, and they try to evaluate their workers. And what if you're that one worker who has been trying to be unique from the group, and I bet you might fall into problems which might cost you your job. So the dress code is very important. If you are expected to appear in a certain attire, please respect that and do so. And the fourth point, the fourth behavior or practice which might cost you your job is complaints. Yeah. When you complain too much, you become boring. When you complain too much, your boss is just going to look at you like, why are you the only one complaining this much? So guys, complaining too much about things that doesn't matter, complaining about everything, you just complain about every little thing. These are some of the things that might cost you your job, because your boss might just find you so boring. And you also have to take individual responsibilities, and you have to also try to work alone and stop complaining. Because in some workplaces, when you complain, okay, maybe your colleagues might come and help you out, but that doesn't speak well, because like I said, there is peer review. Peer review is very important. And when you complain too much, you get so boring. You become so boring, and your boss is just going to be trying to look for a way to get rid of you, and you might lose your job. Another point, the fifth point, which is a practice or a behavior which you might lose your job, is rushing in and out of the office. Yeah, I think this is an important aspect which some people might have not noticed, but this is a behavior or a practice that you might risk losing your job. Yeah, because sometimes some people get so bored sitting in their offices, and you just see them rushing in and out of the office. Maybe they want to rush out to pick something. Oh, I'm just rushing out to send this money to my mom. Oh, I'm rushing out to grab a coffee. Rushing in and out of your office is a bad behavior. If the rule says that the break time is 9:45, you have to sit on your office until it's 9:45, and then you take your break. If the rule says closing time is 2 o'clock, do not try to rush out at 1:30. Those are minute behaviors that you risk losing your job. So please, we should try to pay attention to these minute things. Yes, these are minute things, but they are very important. And you have to actually consider them when you find yourself in a work environment. And if you really want to keep your job, and if you love your job that much, you will take these things into consideration, and you will try to make a change, or you try to make amends. Because sometimes, for example, my boss loves me so much. Yes, una no talk sad proud, please. It's just the truth. Because I try to follow the rules, and I try to live by the rules of the workplace. And the last point, which is the sixth point, yes, it is bad attitude. Some people's attitude is so contagious. Some people have bad character, and it is so contagious to the fact that it affects how they relate and interact with their fellow colleagues or fellow workers. Are you this kind of colleague who has a very snobbish attitude? Are you this kind of colleague who always likes to snob at others? Are you this kind of colleague that even when your other colleagues or fellow colleagues greet you, you find it so difficult to respond? Or even if you respond, you just give them like that kind of snobbish response? Are you that kind of colleague? Ask yourself these questions. Do you look down on others? Do you discredit others at the working place so that you will be considered the best worker? These are important things that you have to ask yourself questions like, why do I have to discredit this other person so that I should be considered the best worker? Some people's bad character can go to that level. Some people can go to the extent of meeting your boss to tell your boss stuff about you so that they can discredit you and so that they can be considered the best workers at the working place. So ask yourself these questions. Do you have this kind of bad attitude? Do you have this kind of bad character? Because bad character, like I said, it is very contagious. And sometimes the bad character even comes as a result of envy and jealousy. Yes. Because when you're envious of someone, you want to be like that person, that's when you start nursing evil intentions in your heart. And that's how it grows out. And then you now take it to your boss to start discrediting your colleague. And these are workplace practices that are very bad that we need to refrain from. These are things that we are not supposed to practice. Other workers are also noticing these behaviors. Of course, they are very keen and they notice these things. Like I said, peer review is very important. Evaluation is very important. And these are the things that they look at during these meetings to evaluate the working place, to evaluate the office, and to evaluate so many other things happening around the work environment. So guys, these are the 6 points which I wanted to share with you guys today in this channel. And lastly, do not forget to always wear a broad smile. Yes, a broad smile actually works magic. I am talking out of experience because I always smile, so I say things out of experience. So please not forget to always wear a broad smile. Even if you're so angry, you're so down, you should try to portray that very bright environment even to your colleagues and fellow workers, so that, because a smile normally brightens one's day, right? Yes, a bright smile brightens one's day. That's why I always try to put on a very broad bright smile every morning. So guys, these are the six or seven? I just added one now, a smile. Yeah, so these are the 7 workplace behaviors that you need to practice every morning at your working place. And if you have been doing any of these things, if you have been portraying bad behavior, if you have been complaining, if you have been snubbing at your colleagues, if you have been looking down on your subordinates, if you have been doing all these things that I've just mentioned in this video, please try to refrain from them. Try to work on yourself, and I bet you your workplace is going to be very comfortable for you. And of course, you're going to be recommended. Is it recommended or commended? Yeah. So thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys so very much. And please, if you like this video, do not forget to subscribe, like, share, and of course you have to drop your opinion down below in my comment section. Like I always say, my comment section is always open for everybody, so you can drop your comment down below in the comment section. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'm going to see you in our next one. Until then, stay blessed. Bye bye.